Y'all don't understand what I'm saying? It doesn't matter if you understand what I'm saying. I'm about to show you how to get your lyrics on all your IG videos and everything else that DistroKid has to offer. Let's talk about it.
So without further ado. Hit that smash button and like it. Subscribe. It's awesome.
What's going on, Big Brain Gang? It's Garrett from Track Sounds back again with another music marketing tutorial. This time we're going to talk about some really cool tips on how to get your lyrics onto IG videos, how to get your credits sent to the store so that way nobody's hitting you up saying, how come I didn't get credit for my help with the song? We're going to cover all that, and all of that is covered by DistroKid, who is the sponsor of the video today. But they have so many cool tools for musicians and artists, producers, everyone under the sun alike. We're going to talk about some new features they have. But I do have a question of the day though first, and this doesn't even have anything to do with the topic today. I'm just kind of curious what y'all think. Who do you think has the best marketing right now in music? When you think of the best marketing, either social media or viral marketing or anything like that, who do you think has the best marketing right now? Rapper, singer, anything in between? Let me know in the comments below. I'm kind of curious who y'all think has the best foot forward in the marketing division. Maybe we can break down what they're doing and how they can help you as well. But anyways, let's get into the tips that you're here for and how to create your music right now. So three really cool features that DistroKid has right now is being able to upload synced video lyrics to Instagram and other things like that. Being able to send credits to the stores for anybody involved in the process. So even the runner can get credit for bringing your bag of chips and backwoods to you. So it's all good on that end. And they also have an AI feature, which we all know I love the buzzword artificial intelligence. And that is going to be able to show you how your song relates up to other songs and compares to some of your other ones, giving you percentage numbers and some other information that is pretty valuable for you going forward. So the first we're going to cover is their new feature of syncing lyrics with DistroKid. So we all know on Instagram or Apple Music, when you see the lyrics scrolling through as a song is playing or something like that, DistroKid has been able to enable all of their users to be able to use this similar feature. And I'm going to show you how to do it with a very simple process. So yeah, as you can see right here, they kind of sync and scroll with the song. And I'll show you how to do it real quick too. I don't have any set lyrics to put it up for, but I'll show you exactly what you would do. So you go here, go into your lyrics, and we'll pick a song. You have to submit plain lyrics first. So you need to just write out your lyrics, have them, and they have all the rules right here that you'll need. You can't, you know, cut off and put chorus times two, things like that. You have to type out everything, make sure it's, you know, grammatically right and things like that for you. Once you submit the plain lyrics, it takes about a week to get approved, maybe a little less. Then you'll be able to go in and do the syncing feature where you can tap and basically add the lyrics as they go along through the song. This is such a cool feature for you because this allows people to really drag onto your song rather than really connect with your song and really analyze it as they're listening. A lot of people listen for melody and don't even hear the words. As artists and producers, we think that everybody hears everything we say, but it's just not true. So putting these lyrics in front of their face is going to be helping them understand the song even more and keep people more interested in the music you have going forward. So another really, really cool feature they added not long ago as well is being able to send all the credits for everybody involved to all of the stores. I'm going to break it down exactly what you can do with it, but this is crucial to make sure that everybody feels like they are involved, especially if they had any little piece in it. Sometimes a lot of people get left out, even if they did get some money or they're getting their publishing as they rightfully should. But at the same time, people need that credit to know that they're being validated and to be able to build up their resume going forward. So let's help everybody and help yourself by doing this small feature from DistroKid. So you go in here to your enhanced music up here in the goodies section, you can go into credits, pick the song you want. No, I'm just gonna pick a random beat I have. So right now I just have me on the music, but say I had a songwriter on it. I could add the songwriter, put their name. You could put their email, even though it won't display on the credits. This way they'll know they were added to it as well. You can pick all types of things. The engineer, the studio, the gear that was used, social media. You can put contact information, acknowledgements. You can change it from a shout out to supporters, all types of things. And these will go to all the different platforms out there that show the credits, Spotify, Tidal, Apple Music, different things like that. And I personally find a lot of people in credits. If I like a song, I will go into the credits, see who worked on it, possibly to collaborate or network on my end. But other people will go in there and find out who they may want to listen to going forward or who is really working on some of their favorite records. So definitely do this step. This will add a lot of transparency and fans love the back information on there. One of the last really cool features that they added that I personally like, I was going to make a video about something very similar to this, and I will pretty soon because I think this is a great way to analyze your own songs. One thing S1 told me, who's a really big producer, he told me a while back that he took the top 20 songs on the Billboard charts or different charts, and he would analyze them by key, BPM, feel, drums, and things like that, and see what are some of the things that are really sticking through and showing like, hey, these are the most popular keys in the Billboard right now. These are the most popular BPMs. Dave, which is DistroKid's artificial intelligence bot, as you know, AI is the hot word, buzzword. They have their own program now that will analyze your songs that are up and give you some really good analysis of this going forward, especially some things you might need. If you don't know the key of your song, if you're not the producer of it, some people won't know. So let's analyze. Let's put some analysis on one of my tracks, and I'll kind of show you what they do. Tells you how long the song is, tells you what key the song is in, tells you where the loudness is. That's a little lower than I like, so I must have, you know, this is just the beat I put up, so I maybe needed to crank it up a little more. Tells you the tempo. Then they talk into the, you know, the elements of the track, the acousticness, the danceability, the instrumentalness, which is a funny word to me, energy, you know, this track on the mellow side, speech, you know, it's a beat, so there's not much speech in it as all. So you're gonna analyze. So take this information and use this keys, the BPMs, things like that, and find songs that have been doing well for you or people that are fans or you've been getting good feedback on, and try to make more songs in that style. Don't try to go against the curve of what people like. Find some, use the analysis, find stuff that is working for you, and keep doubling down on the same type of keys, BPMs, feels, and all types of things like that. These are just a few more quick tips that DistroKid has put out, but they're very, very vital for musicians, producers, artists, everybody going forward. I do have a VIP code for 7% off your first year on DistroKid that I will link in the description and right here. If you're needing a distributor or if you're wanting to switch to my favorite one out there right now, which is DistroKid, I promise it will be worth it. But if you have any other questions or comments moving forward, let me know below. And until I see y'all next time, peace.
Smash it. Smash the like button, please. Like this channel. Garrett is awesome.